Those of you who have been complaining that there's no tea in the video, note, tea. Right, hello and welcome to the Geek Club. And by popular demand, today we're going to be playing Oregon Trail, which I've played through once. So I thought I'd record a playthrough again. Hopefully it will be as kind to me as it was last time we can do this. I'm going to play this today on the venerable old Macintosh LCii here. Yes. Ah, changes colour nicely there. Oh, well, it goes back to yucky colour when we look at the screen there. Oh, well. Let's see. Does that jump? Nope. Okay, well, anyway. So, we're going to have a go at this. This machine is, I think it's a 16 megahertz processor, 10 megabytes of memory, and a 40 megabyte hard disk. One of the few machines I know where the hard disk is only four times the size of the memory. They're usually a hell of a lot bigger. So, we're going to go for the Oregon Color. And Jenny Rossman rules, apparently. Nice sip of tea. Note, tea. Video makes that frame look quite yellowed. I know it is quite yellowed, but it makes it look even more quite yellowed. But there we go. Right, so load the game, The Oregon Trail. If you don't know what it is, it's an educational program from the 80s. And it's basically designed to teach people about settlers travelling across the United States in the early days, obviously. And teach you something about making decisions based on an adventure in doing that. You can die of dysentery in this game. All sorts of nastiness can get you. Well, we're going to find out. Welcome to the Oregon Trail. You're about to begin a great adventure traveling the Oregon Trail across the rugged landscape of North America. Your covered wagon, pulled by a team of oxen, will travel from Independence, Missouri to the fertile Willamette Valley of the Oregon Territory. A journey of approximately 2,000 miles. Ouch. Before you set off on the trail, you must register your name, the names of the members of your wagon party, and your occupation. After that, you'll need to buy supplies and make other important decisions. Good luck. Okie dokie. So, my name is Butch Smuckle. Oh, no E, won't fit. Evidence there. See, it won't let me put the E on. That'll do. Now, what am I going to be? I'm going to be... I'll be a blacksmith this time. Other people in your wagon? You can change those names, but there you go. I can't be asked. And obviously get this. Up here, the options are quite simple. Export game, quit. Cut, copy, paste. Sound on and off. And about money. What's management? Right, you can change all the characteristics of a game and customize it. Okay. I need to get its password. I'm sure I can get that online if I really wanted to get it. Right, Butch Schmuckle, here we go. Okay. Let's buy some supplies. Now we got $800 and things to buy. So, oxen. I'm going to buy me 6 oxen. Make sure that cart gets pulled nicely. Sets of clothing. Now we've got 5 people, so I'm going to get 6 sets of... I'm going to buy... 8. That'll do. Boxes of bullets. 20 in the box. $2 each. I'm going to buy me... 10 boxes. Give me... Oh, no. I think I got about 40 boxes last time, but I didn't use them all. So, 10 boxes is 20. I didn't fire that many last time, so we shall see. Spare wagon wheels. You're going to need them. Buy 3. Spare axe wheel. Spare wagon tongs. I have no idea what wagon tongs are, but I'm getting 3 of them. Pounds of food. So, we can max out on the food. 2. There we go. And I still haven't spent all the money, so what shall I buy? What should I buy? I've got 200 bullets. No, we'll stay at that. Bye. Now there's an important decision to be made. You need to decide when to set off on the trail. If you leave too early, there won't be much grass for your oxen to eat. You may encounter some very cold weather and late spring snowstorms. We don't want that. But if you leave too late, you may not get to Oregon before winter, which can be very dangerous. If you leave at just the right time, there will be green grass and, for the most part, mild weather. So I'm going to leave in April, because that's when the good weather starts to start. This does even English. England? English? England. If you can class any of England's weather as good. Okay. We are into the main game, ready to depart. So, that's how quick you got here. You've got a map. Map, thank you. And you can see the Oregon Trail. Mountains, river, trails, red. Landmark and fort. Doesn't show the trail at the moment. It only shows up once you've done it. Right, you get a guide to each location. The town of Independence in western Missouri is one of the chief starting points for folks setting off on the Oregon Trail. Immigrants from the east would often rendezvous here to form wagon trains. They stock up on supplies, get information about the journey, and make important decisions, such as when to set off on the trail. And you can see the status of all your stuff you've bought. States your rations. I'm going to Meager. You can buy stuff, so takes you back to the shop. You can trade stuff if you need. You can talk to locals. Always a good idea to talk to locals. And that looks a little bit like Tom Cruise. Did you read the Missouri Republican today? Yes, I did. It was the first thing I thought of. Says some folks start for Oregon without carrying spare parts. Not even an extra white wagon axle. Must think they grow on trees. Hope they're lucky enough to find an abandoned wagon. Whoops, sorry, my memory card's getting a bit low there, so I had to interrupt. Right, where were we? Talk. You can rest. Handy when people get sick. You can set the pace. A steady pace. We'll go for a steady pace. Good. And you can go hunting. You can't do that here. Won't let you. Hunting is not allowed near Independence, Missouri, because there are too many people around. At first I was trying to hunt at the different venues. Wouldn't let me. Hang on, just a bit. But eventually I found you can only hunt when you're trans... Well, you can only appear to hunt when you're do my head in that. When you're transiting, so... I shall demonstrate that on the way. Each screen you get the conditions, sunny, mid date, 1848 for April 1st, mid temperature, distance gone, nothing, wagon conditions, and there you go. And your log of what you're doing. So, let's continue down the trail. Okay, and we're off. You get a little animation showing you traveling, and things will change. There you go, food's going down, health will remain good probably, and you can fast forward this, but we're not going to. I'm going to talk you to death all the way through it, and it should stop at this river where you'll get some decisions to be made. Here we go. Kansas River Crossing. You have reached the Kansas River Crossing. Now, if you don't you can look at the guide. Kansas River is a tributary to the Missouri and is approximately 170 miles long. Its width and depth vary depending on the amount of recent rain or snowmelt. There you go. Be sure to check the present conditions when you get there. Okay. Right. Let's talk to somebody. This is obviously somebody around. Don't try to ford any river deeper than a wagon bed. About 2.5 feet, you'll swamp your wagon and lose your supplies. You can cork the wagon bed and float it, or be smart and hire me to take your wagon on my ferry. So we've got some tips there. Okay, continue. Take a ferry for $5. How much money have I got? Loads. I'm going to take the simple option. Crossing the river. You made it safely across the river. Hey! It's the sound on enough, but you don't get much sound unless you're hunting, I think. We are travelling again. You can see our position has changed here on the overall map. There it goes. And we've covered... it's 23 miles to our next landmark, and we've travelled 180 miles. Okay, so we've reached the Big Blue River crossing. Let's have a look at some information about this. Let's talk to people. We've had enough pesky flies all day and mosquitoes all night. It's either baking sun or oceans of mud, and sometimes both worry. Both. Worry over Indians attacking. Haven't seen any yet, but still a worry. Health is fair. So, let's have a look at status. Sarah's got cholera. Tell you what. Let's get some information. The Big Blue River is a tributary of the Kansas River, which is in turn a tributary to the Missouri. It's approximately 300 miles long. Far to the south and west is the Little Blue River, which links up with the Big Blue at Blue Rapids. There's a lot of blue in this, isn't there? You'll cross the Big Blue north of the rapids, allowing you to avoid the Little Blue River altogether. There you go. Got an index. Ooh, posh. Anyway, what I'm going to do, because we have some illness, we've got cholera on board, I'm going to give us 2 days rest. Food is good, it's 180 pounds, so we don't have to worry about that. There we go, we are resting, as you can see the air flashing away. Resting is a cup of tea time. Okay. Wagon stopped. Okay, we are finished resting. And how are we doing? Health is fair. Let's have a look. How can you still be... Oh, I don't know. Right. Attempt to ford the river. Attempt to chalk the wagon and float it. 3.5 feet deep. Go on then. See what happens. Do 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 do. Let's see if we make it. Do we make it? Oh, yes. We made it safely across. Okay, thank you. We are continuing. Well, the green everywhere appears to be green around here. We're heading for. Where are we heading for? Doesn't say. But that looks, look at this, we can see it from 47 miles away. You can see this hut from 47 miles away. Amazing. Lack of pollution over there makes conditions amazing. Oh, we're delayed. Why are we delayed? Excuse me, you've lost a trail. Sarah as well again. Thank you. Delayed. Okay. What's timeout do? You decided to call the timeout. No, then. Continue. Delayed. Right, and we're off and going to see this building, which you can now see from 9 miles. There we go. Ooh, like the artwork there. Looks good. You have reached Fort Kearney. Oh, that's good. Let's have a look at the map. Fort Kearney is a U.S. Army post established in 1848 near the Platte River. It garrisons cavalry troops who protect shelters and travelers along the Oregon Trail. It was named for General Stephen Watts Kearney, often spelled K-E-A-R-N-E, who died in 1848 after helping to establish law and order in the region and serving in the Mexican War. So, we're good. Food left, 1750. Let's have a look at our status. We are good. Everybody's fair. I'll push on. Push on. Let's talk to somebody. The Platte River Valley forms a natural roadway from Fort Kearney to Fort Laramie. Travelers bound for California, Utah, and Oregon all take this road. It could be the easiest stretch of the whole trip. Should see antelope and plenty of buffalo. In other words, it's good for hunting. Right. Let's continue. You decided to continue. I have to get my map back. I thought it had automatically switched to the map, but obviously not. Okay, let's have a look at the hunting. If I time out, we can go for a hunt. Get ready to hunt. Don't really need to hunt, but I'm going to show you anyway. It's a fun little game. Right, you've got different creatures. But you've got to shoot ahead of them, or else you won't. Oh, God. Bunny rabbits. Missed him. Got him. Be my victim. Oh, not doing well here. Bloody bunnies. Come here, buddy. Yes. 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 Oh. Oh, bunny. You must die, bunny. Okay. Out comes hunting. You brought back 4 pounds of food and used 15 bullets. Okay. So, yeah, it wasn't the best hunt ever, because they only had bunnies. If you have buffalo and stuff, then you get much more. That's the only sound you really get in the game, is the sound of shooting. And even that's quiet. Need more volume. Aye, aye. AT brake. Lest it recur, well, it travels further down the Oregon Trail. You had a wagon axle brake, but were able to fix it. Oh, how good. Okay, 210 miles to the landmark. Food's going down slightly. Oh, we got delayed. You've lost the trail. That's what you get for using sat-nav and not programming it right. Oh, I don't know these people. Come on. Delayed. We are delayed. Who's doing the tarification course? I'm going to shoot them in the ass. The ass. Oh, health's good, though. They've had a rest. We are moving. Hey, I said 6 oxen, and there's only 2 there. The hell? Where the rest? Must be behind. Uh-oh. There's a turd in the road. Oh, no. Sarah has the measles, and we've got bad water. Oh, no, this is not going to be... No water. Already? The hell? Chimney Rock. You have reached Chimney Rock. Congratulations. Thank you. Guide. Chimney Rock is an important landmark on the Oregon Trail. It's a spectacular natural formation of solid poo. And can be seen for miles around. In fact, you can see it for a whole day as you approach it, and for another whole day as you leave it behind. If you don't see it at all within a week or so after leaving Fort Keeney, you're probably strayed too far off the trail. Smug it. Right, we need water. What do you want to get by trading? None of that. Need water. Cancel. We can't rest because we've got no water. Is there somebody to talk to? About noon yesterday we came in sight of Chimney Rock looming up in the distance like the lofty tower of some town. We did not tire gazing on it. It was about 20 miles from us and stayed in sight till we reached it today, which means it's bloody flat around there. Right, continue. No water. Getting thirsty. Must have tea. Yes, we know, got no water. Nope, yep, no water. Uh-oh, health is poor. Well, luckily we got a fort here. No grass for the oxen. Emery has cholera. Oh, come on, last time you let me do this easy. Now you're fighting me. Sarah died? No! So, how do I get water? Guide. Fort Laramie is a U.S. Army post near the junction of North Platte and the Laramie Rivers. Originally called Fort William, it was founded as a fur trading post in 1834. It was renamed for Jacques Lemien, a French trapper who worked in the region earlier in the century. Fort Lemien is an important stop and resting stop for resting and getting supplies along the trail. Right, let's see. Uh, I've $85, so I'm going to top up my food. I need 300... No, 400... Oh, 400. 490 pounds of food. No, no, don't want that. Half 300? How much is 300? Nope. I'll go for 200 pounds of food. Half... Bye. Okay, let's rest, shall we? I'm going to take 2 days out here and rest. Resting, let's see how people are doing. Status. Deceased. Poor, cholera, poor, poor. Well, we've got enough food to... I'm going to rest another couple of days. 4 days. Because everybody's feeling unwell. Okay, what I'm going to do as well is up the rations a little bit to help the health. Chat status. Fair, fair. Emily's still got cholera. Rest another day. Just see if we can get rid of that cholera sorted. Hey, Emily is well again. Food is good. Okay, we may continue. Boink. Yes, we're off. And... there we go, 178 miles to next to landmark. And we're delayed, so what I'm going to do is go hunting. Yes! See if we can get anything decent, better than bunny rabbits. Right, come on. Okay. Go, go, go. One! Come on. It was stated in the group the other day that stated in the group the other day, woohoo, that a lot of people don't notice how noisy old hard drives are. Believe me, when you're using the LCII, you notice. Let's move. Let's get something else. Anything good? Bison. Easy. Okay, you shot at 835 pounds of fuse using 5 bullets. Thank you. You are only able to carry 200 pounds of food back to your wagon if you continue. You little shit. So I could have saved all those bullets. Hey. Oh well. Let's continue. We're still delayed. Don't think I need to worry about the food too much. We are on the move. And the landscape's changing. Yay! And it's rainy. Raining in my heart. Emily was bitten by a snake. Ooh. I found some wild fruit. Did that top us up any? Probably not. How are the rations doing? They're good. We are running steady. Rations are filling at the moment. Who died? Shite. That's 2 dead. Huh. Loads of people got bit by snake bites last time, but nobody died. I'll have to keep an eye out for that then. Let's continue. Bye bye, Emily. Everything's fair. Food's going down. We are 64 miles to landmark. Whatever the landmark is. Don't tell ya. I've just gotta... what's this? Somebody's been dumping cement in the middle of nowhere. Bloody contractors. Getting warm. Health's still fair. Food is going down. Right. Right, we are stopped. You have reached Independence Rock. Yay! Looks like we've got a camp. Right. Let's have a look at the guide. Independence Rock is an important landmark and resting place along the Oregon Trail. It's a large natural formation, almost 200 feet tall, made of soft stone into which many travellers and traders have carved their names, initials, or brief messages like, "Back off!" It gets its name from the fact that, in order to stay on schedule, travellers try to reach it no later than 4th of July, Independence Day. What do we are? June 18th. I am fine. Right, let's talk. Let's see if we get any hints. I carved my name on the side of Independence Rock near the top. Congratulations, Ted. There are hundreds of names up there. The oldest ones were carved by mountain men and fur trappers. Famous names like Fremont, Bonneville, and De Smet. Never heard of them. Right, let's rations. Let's drop the rations. Actually, let's just up the pace, see what happens. Strenuous pace. Go. We are off. 102 miles to the next landmark. Joey has cholera. Oh, God. I don't want anybody else dying, so we're going to have to stop. Rest for 3 days. See if that cures her. It's definitely making it harder than it did last time. It was pretty easy walkthrough last time. June 25th, 1848. Alright, let's have a look at our status. Deceased. Somebody, Butch Muckles Fair. Cholera Fair. Oh, this is terrible. Right, let's rest for another 2 days. 2 days, go! I have no idea. Joey's well again. Yes! Yes! Let's go. Oh, we can't hunt around here, can we? Can we hunt? Oh, we can. Okay. Let's hunt. I like to keep the food stocks up high so we can get plenty. Right. Go shoot a couple of them and we should be good. Anybody else? Huh? There. Missed him. Yes! That should be good. Yay! There we go. Thank you very much. Okay. Right, let's continue. You decided to continue. Thank you for telling me that. What it does at the end, so you can save a log of what you did. So that's very good. And you could actually print that if you had the printer hooked up. I don't have it hooked up today. Right, South Pass. Let's have a look. South Pass is a valley that cuts through the Rocky Mountains at the highest point, the Continental Divide. It marks the halfway point on your journey to Oregon. After South Pass, the trail splits. If you're short on supplies, you should head for Fort Bridger. But if you don't need supplies, you may want to take the shorter route and go directly to Green River. I shall do that then. When the white man first crossed our lands, their wagons were few. Now they crowd the trail in great numbers. The land is overgrazed with many animals. Do any white men still live in the east? My people talk of moving. Okay, let's go. Oh, we're going to the Green Cross, aren't we? Yeah. Continue. Thank you. We are moving? Yep, we're moving. Thought I might hit the timeout then. Okay, 107 miles to go, it's sunny, and everything's fair. The food is going down a little bit faster than I'd like, so let's change the rations to meager. Good, change the rations to meager. Jed is bitten by a snake. Time out. Rest. 4 days. See if we can fix him. We don't want him, another one dying on us. Last time I got through this with everybody. Everybody survived. Health is fair. Food's going down. Slowly. And stopped. Fair. Let's have a look. Status. Jed snakebite. Fair. And me fair. Alright, may as well continue. My occupation is still blacksmith. Doesn't seem to make... Oh, it does. Gee, blacksmith. Yeah. If you're blacksmith, you can do the... There we go. You can repair stuff. So, it's very hot. Green River Crossing. Okay, which is Green River Crossing? Guide. Green River is a tributary of the Colorado River, flowing south from the Continental Divide along a twisted, rugged path. It's estimated to be more than 700 miles in long. 700 miles in long? In length. It's navigable only at high water, and even then it's extremely dangerous, but you must cross it before proceeding west on the Oregon Trail. So be very, very careful. Ooh. Right, okay. Talk. My family didn't buy enough food in Independence. We have been eating very small rations since Fort Lorraine. Because of that, our health is poor. My sister has mountain fever, so we stopped here for a while. We are good on food, so we are continuing. Attempt to ford the river. Take a ferry ride. $5. I'll take the ferry ride. Crossing the river, crossing the river, crossing the river all day. Yeah, we made it. Oh, God. Oh, another snake bite. Bastards. Right, time out, time out, time out. Rest. 4 days. Okay. And while we're resting, let's go hunting. Because we can. Right, come on. Doom, 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 doom. Little shit. Ah. Okay, that'll do. We have got enough there. Ah. Only £50? What the hell? I want 200. I want to max out. Let's try again. Oh, okay. Anybody else? Move. Somewhere else. Right, see what happens. If anything. Ah. Yes. Need more food for family. Come on. Anybody? Or have I stripped the place of all its animals? No. Oh. Spreadlinkle! Hey. Thank you. Right, stop hunting. Let's see what we got. 493. There we go. Right, continue. Okay. Continue. Alright, we are moving. We are fair health. And we're on our way to the next landmark, which is 18 miles away. Okay, it's cloudy and dropping temperature. Good. July 28th. Joey got sick and died. Oh, God. Continue. Status. We're both poor. Map. Am I going to survive the Oregon Trail on this attempt? You have reached Soda Springs. Right, I think we need to rest again. I have to do this last time. Soda Springs is an important landmark and stopping off point along the trail. It gets its name from the alkaline sodium mineral springs you find here. Some travellers separate from the Oregon Trail at this point and head southwest to California. Others await until they get to Fort Hall before going on the California Trail. Southwest California. Okay, talk. I've heard it said there are many cutoffs to take too short on the journey. By taking all the shortcuts, you can save many days on the trail. And why not? Saving time and provisions is worth the risk. Huh? I've had a lot of risk recently. Right. Okay, we're in bad health, so let's take 4 days off. Yes. Resting. And our health has gone fair, so doing something right. Right, okay, and food and everything's good, so let's continue. Looks like we're 2/3 of the way through. And we found something else, 39 miles away, 21 miles away. Faster than a speeding bullet. Oh no, I lost the trail. I can see it! Delayed. No water. Oh no. Lucky we're 21 miles away from the next place. Although doing 21 miles without water might be considered a bit dangerous. Right, come on. Ah, we're off. Right. 3 miles and Bazinga. We are at Fort Hall. Woo. Guide. Fort Hall is an outpost on the banks of the Snake River. It was originally a fur trading post founded by a national in 1834. Later it was bought by the Hudson Bay. Some travellers turned southwest as a point ahead for California. Okay, status. Deceased. Fair. $20 money, we are all good. Let us continue a room. Map. Butch Smuckle is continuing his adventure. Health is poor. Oh god, been bitten by a snake and there's bad water. Keep moving. No grass for the oxen. Must keep moving. If there's no grass, we can't stop, really, can we? Oh dear. No grass for the oxen. They'll survive. Oh, we've lost the trail. Oh, why is it doing this? It was so much nicer to me the first time. Now it's not being nice. I'm going to tell. Right, moving. Okay. Health is poor. No water. There's a river here, 52 miles away. No grass. Well, there should be water near a... Sorry. Grass near a river. Jet as well again. Woohoo! Health is very poor. Pushing on. Severe storm. Very poor. Very, very poor. We're going to have to rest for a week or so here. You have reached the Snake River crossing. Whew! Guide. Follows the Snake River. The Snake River gets its name in there. Very fat, though dry and desolate. We need to rest. 6 days. Because there's water here. This could be good, or it could be very, very bad. Oh, it's going up. So it's good. Tell you what. Let's up the rations. Filling. What's the pace? Steady pace. Okay. Health is fair. Wagon has stopped. Status. Fair. Measles. Rest for another few days. You can have another 2 days, okay? Another 2 days. Okay. We're filling rations. And then we'll go for the hunt, I think, again. Come on. Let's see how everything goes. Jed as well again. Good. Right. Hire an Indian to help for 3 sets of clothes. Go on then. Who needs clothes? Yes, we made it. Yes, thank you, Indians, for not scalping me. As we always have, you believe. Found some wild fruit, and the oxen should be fed nicely, so we can continue. You can get quite engrossing for this, saying there's no actual true video or anything. It's just status displays, basically. Can get quite engrossing. Change my position, getting dead legs. Right, we're 30 miles from something. Health is good. Oh, good. That bit of rations, filling rations. Oh, God, Jed is a pain in the ass. Let's get to this place. Trailer's impassable. Oh, okay. Delayed. Health is good. Again, that's good. Food is going down. But we need... There we go. We need that. Right, continue. Oh. No. Well, everything's good, so we can continue anyway. We... I thought it was saying continue from the stop. But we actually got to the landmark, so no, well, missed the landmark. But we should be good until the next one. Let's go hunting. Get ready to hunt. Right then, let's kick some ass. Yes, and a big booger should fill us up nicely. We got, oof, yep, 200 pounds back. Okay, we're good. Continue. We are moving again, 2 of us left. Do, 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 do. Health is, for change, good. 128 miles, 116 miles to our next destination. Pace is steady. Rations are filling. Yes, we like filling rations. Dee 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 dee. Uh-oh, what's now? The trail is impassable. I didn't have this at all on the first attempt. This has definitely been a more difficult attempt. It's definitely trying to kick my ass this time. It's being merciless. Well, it shows that each time you get a different game, which is good. You found 33 bullets and 2 wagon wheels in an abandoned wagon. That's cool. Ooh, what's this? We found something. Ooh, come on. Partly cloudy. Cooling down. Health is good. Everything's good at the moment. See if we can make it all the way to the end. Right, Grand Ronde and the Blue Mountains. You have reached Grande Ronde in the Blue Mountains. Oh, that's nice. Guide. The Grande Ronde, French for Great Ring, is a river that runs roughly parallel to the Blue Mountains. The Oregon Trail crosses through the Grande Ronde River Valley just before the mountains. Okay. Sign the long journey is nearing its end. Right, everything's good. Yep, we are good. We don't need... Let's just talk just in case. We followed the edge of the desert from Fort Boyce to the forbidding wall of the Blue Mountains. The hills were dreadful steep, locking both wheels and coming down slow. We got down safe, poor animals, no grass or water for days. We're good. We'll take it. Here we go. We'll take the shortcut. We are generally in good health. Let's see what happens. It's going to kick me off now. We've got plenty of food, so no issues there. 89 miles. Oh, it's getting so tense, isn't it? Amazing how long this game goes for as well.
Quite a while.
Delayed, you took the wrong trail. Ted, navigator, you are bad. Stop eating. I think I'll probably make it to the end now without
filling up on food.
Right, you took the wrong trail. Wagon is moving, apparently. 29 miles. 17 miles. It's already there, going slower. 5 miles, moving good. Everything's good. Final is good. We are at the Dales. Right. Okay, guide. The Dales is a chief embarkation point for rafts heading down the Columbia River towards the Willamette Valley. It was named by French fur trappers who likened the deep stony river gorge to a huge gutter. In French, the word Dales can refer to gutters or flagstones. Emigrants to Oregon often stop here to rest and trade before rafting down the Columbia. Okay. Talk. Let's get some tips. I collect the tolls for the Barbellette Road, a bargain at twice the price. Until last year, the Overlander had no choice. Everyone floated the Columbia. Now, with Mr. Barlow's new road, you can drive your wagon right into Oregon City. Sounds good. What have I got? Status. No, it's not that one. $20 on money. Right, okay. Continue. It doesn't tell you how much it is. How much was that then? Not $5. Okay. Jed was bitten by a snake. Jada died of snake bite.
Wow, that happened quick.
And health good. The hell? I'm continuing.
Bloody hell.
Hey. That came out of nowhere. So there's just me left on this one. Whereas last time, I got everybody across. It's definitely in a worse mood this time. I wonder if it knows I'm back. Ooh, it's got it in for me. Wagon delayed. Health is good.
Well, at least I'm using less food now. Probably going to make it to the end unless something bites me
again. Nothing's bit me so far. Bit everybody else. Killed them all. Everybody died apart from me. And I'm trying to... Ah, there we go. I was trying to fill in there while it does nothing. We are moving again.
No water.
Ugh! Trail is impassable. What a load of wank stain. Excuse my French. Okay. Right, we are off. No water, but we got this thing here, so... We are now reaching stuff on the map before it gets there here. Is that a bug in it? Because it didn't do that last time. Rough trail. Still moving. Health is fair. 4 miles, and we are arriving at...
Excuse me.
You've reached the Willamette Valley. Continue. Yay. Whew. You arrived on November 13th, 1848, and received the following number of points. One person arriving in good health, times 500. One wagon, times... That's still got me a wagon.
Yeah, so you can lose your wagon.
Six oxen,
24 points.
Nine spare parts, five sets of clothing, 193 bullets. A lot of food,
$15.
Blacksmith bonus times two is 1,334. You did not make it to the list of the legends, but better look next time. What's the list of legends? Can I see their scores? Ah. Okay, so we did it. We did the Oregon Trail. Well, I did the Oregon Trail. Everybody else died. But there you go. That is a walkthrough of the Oregon Trail. A very good game, and I do suggest you play it either, you know, on the original hardware like this, or you emulate it. However you do it. Do it, because it's good. So, if you're not already subscribed and you enjoy this sort of video, then please subscribe. And there are links downstairs to social media, such as Facebook and Twitter, and Patreon if you wish to support the channel. Other than that, I'd just like to say, I hope I've got your interest in this game. If you've played it, if you've got any good memories of it, or bad memories of it, then let me know in the comments, please. And thank you all very much.
You need to quit being dirty. You're a dirty boy.